The next show is planned for April 9th, 2022. It's about 29 weeks to bring something really special to the stage. I am very confident that that's going to happen. People, welcome to the voiceover portion of this video. So I'm just going to give you a quick walkthrough of this workout. Today was chest and arms, so that is what we're going to do. So you can see here, starting with flat barbell bench press, I've recently threw in the flat press in, and it's a movement with me that we have a love-hate relationship. It really hits my chest. I feel it. I'm sore the next day, but I have to be very, very careful because it is easy for me to, start to wreak havoc on my shoulders and kind of that upper end of the bicep tendon there where it kind of attaches into your shoulder. So, you know, for me, it's being smart about how I do it, you know, how I progress with it. You can see here we did a top set of 280 for 5 and then a back off set of 230 for, I believe, 15 reps. So that's, you know, how I typically structure it with a top set and a back off set. For one of the bigger movements of this session. Going into the second movement, we've got a kind of a medium incline Smith press, so hitting a little bit more of the upper chest. This feels great, but it definitely is heavy after doing the heavy flat pressing first. You can see here I got two plates on there, and the Smith is actually a 55-pound bar, so when it comes to tracking load, I just call it a regular 45-pound bar just for simple math, but it's actually a 55-pound bar, so everything on there, you technically would add 10 pounds to the total if you were to track it in that manner. So same with the flat barbell, we do a top set and a back off set. Unfortunately, by the time I got to the back off set, it was quite heavy, so I think next week I'll dial back the load on that back off set even more to try to hit a higher rep range because, if I remember correctly, I only got 7 or 8 reps. But I prefer to get a little bit higher on the back off set, somewhere around maybe 12 reps. So I will adjust for that next week. And then our fly movement for this session, just kind of a standard cable fly, a little bit of a kind of an angle on the torso there, just focusing on good contractions with the chest. When it comes to flies, I typically prefer a bit of a higher rep range just to get, you know, really good quality contractions in my chest. I find it's a movement that if I go too heavy, I just start throwing the weight around, just trying to muscle it around, which is not necessarily the goal with a fly, in my opinion. I think it's a movement that if you go a little bit lighter on, you're probably going to get a little bit more out of it. Then we go to dumbbell press to finish off the chest portion of the session. Two sets, a similar rep range across both sets, if I remember correctly. And you can see here on the first one, things are moving pretty good, but it starts to get pretty damn heavy pretty quick. I don't remember exactly what I had for weight on these movements. Those adjustable dumbbells go up to 90, and I think I was 80 or 85 for the first set, and then I did drop it back, although I mentioned earlier that it was the same rep range. It's not. I dropped it back a little bit just to get a little bit more on the second set, but again, still getting relatively heavy around that 10 to 12 rep range for that. So that was chest, and then going into arms, I only recorded a little bit of stuff just because I didn't want to record every single set for arms, but everything you're seeing here is superset. So we're starting with incline dumbbell curls and then rope press downs for triceps. I just prefer to run arms with a little bit more of a superset approach. One, it's really effective for me when it comes to training my arms. I get good connection with it. I feel good. You know, it gets a lot of blood in the arms in both the biceps and the triceps all at the same time. And efficiency-wise, if you're on a time crunch, it's an easy way to do it. And it's you know, one of those muscle groups, like with arm training, you can superset it, and I find it doesn't take away from, you know, the other movement. So by the time I go to, you know, the rope press down, for example, from the incline curl, even though my biceps are toast, I'm still going into the press down feeling fresh for my triceps. So we did three sets, and then for the second superset, we've got a rope cable curl here, kind of a hammer curl variation. And then dumbbell skull crushers, again, three sets. I typically go higher rep range on the first two movements, and then like a moderate rep range for the middle and the last superset, just because I find doing the lighter stuff first, you know, gets my elbow joints really warmed up and gets a lot of blood in there, and then I can go into the heavy stuff and already be, you know, quite connected with the muscle group. And then to finish, dumbbell curls and rope overhead extensions. These are the last sets because I do a drop set, you'll see here. So we did just standard dumbbell curl, both arms at the same time, nothing fancy. Once I hit, you know, pretty much failure, I grabbed lighter dumbbells to really kind of just burn the biceps out to finish. I just kind of took those to failure as well. And same with the rope overhead extension, doing you know, kind of a standard 10 to 12 reps and then dropping the load and doing a drop set to finish off for arms. So that is the workout. You know, everything's going really well. Going into this session, my body felt good, and you know, every single movement was good quality. It was good. Just a good session, right? Like, if you can string together really good sessions throughout your prep, you can willing to bet that it's going to be a successful prep. So I'll catch you guys in the next clip, whatever that may be.
All right, guys. So I'm just going to close this out with a quick little update on where things are at with prep. So the workout you saw, chest and arms, was technically like 24 weeks out, but I'm recording this on Sunday. Today is October 24th, 25th. So yesterday was 23 weeks out. So we hit a new low this week of 168.7 pounds. If you guys are following me on Instagram, you'd already know that because I posted about it yesterday. And I've definitely never looked this good at this body weight before and this far out from the show. I really am excited for what's to come, because just with how this prep is going, how smoothly it's going, how good I feel, you know, mentally, physically, I'm just really in a good spot, really excited about this prep and, you know, what's to come. And I think I've just really set myself up for success throughout the prep, and, you know, giving myself the timeline that I have, which actually got bumped up a week. So the original show was April 9th. And now my intro is all wrong because the show got moved up to April 2nd. I saw that on the schedule this past week. So, you know, that really doesn't change anything, like, especially with how far out I am and the physique that, you know, where I currently am at. You know, we didn't feel like we've lost any time really, or that we're rushed now at all. So, you know, really nothing has changed except for, you know, technically the date is now a week earlier than originally planned. But yeah, I just, you know, I don't want to talk about how good everything's going, because I think a lot of people expect prep to kind of just be this grind the entire time, and, you know, you're just digging yourself into the ground. And, you know, in some cases that may be, but for me right now, I don't feel, you know, it really doesn't feel like I'm prepping all that much. Don't get me wrong, there's times when you're hungry and, you know, you get those blood sugar dips when your hands start to get shaky and stuff. But as a whole, you know, training performance is great. You know, hunger's manageable. You know, we still do weekly refeeds, which was yesterday, so I get to enjoy, you know, a little bit extra food on those days. I'm not doing any cardio still. You know, so really, like, outside of the technicality that I'm prepping and the a little bit more structure with food and restriction, you know, it's not it's not a battle at all right now. And, you know, hopefully we can ride that out as long as we can. I know there's going to be hard times ahead and there's going to be challenges and, you know, those moments where it's like, man, like this is starting to hurt. But, you know, I don't foresee that happening for quite some time. And if we can continue to move forward at the pace that we are and, you know, get ready with plenty of time to spare, we can really kind of go into the shows feeling good, which is obviously never a bad thing. So, yeah, just wanted to kind of end this video off with a little chat. You know, I know people are enjoying these Operation 2022, these kind of weekly uploads. So I appreciate the support and messages that I've gotten. And, you know, we're going to continue to do this definitely up until the show. And for any shows that follow the first one, we'll obviously document all that time too. So if you guys are enjoying the video, please give it a like. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next one.